Well, we are joined this morning by Dr. David Richardson. He's a Southern California board certified eye surgeon specializing in the treatment of cataracts and glaucoma.
Dr. Richardson is here to talk about his new book, So You've Got a Cataract, What You Need to Know About Cataract Surgery, A Patient's Guide to Modern Eye Surgery, Advanced Intraocular Lenses, and Choosing Your Surgeon. Thanks so much for joining us. And, you know, there's so many misconceptions. Can you tell us, what is cataract and what are really the symptoms?
Yes, cataract is actually a natural process that occurs as we age. It's something that if we're fortunate enough to live long enough, we're all going to get. And the good news is that there is a wonderful treatment for cataracts. The symptoms of cataracts generally include blurred vision, glare or halos around lights, especially these newer, brighter lights that we have on the freeways, difficulty reading, and loss of saturation in colors. So blues become more of a yellow, and you just lose a bit of the vibrancy. When these symptoms get to the point that one's what we call activities of daily living are affected, and that includes reading, driving, could be golf, you get to decide. Then it's time to consider treatment for cataract surgery. And if glasses alone or contacts do not get the vision to the point that it needs to be for the individual, then cataract surgery would be the next step.
And doctor, is that a painful procedure?
Oh no, no. Cataract surgery with the modern techniques should be painless. In fact, many people view it as an interesting experience. It's done under local anesthetic, and many people are awake, relaxed during the surgery, and notice interesting colors, shapes, patterns. Some describe it as almost a psychedelic, pleasant experience, but it really should not be painful, no.
But how do you know that you're going to the right surgeon? How do you choose the surgeon to do the procedure?
It's a very good question. I actually dedicate a chapter in my book to that issue. And two key concepts that I think are worth considering is, one, to recognize that just because a surgeon is on your panel in the insurance doesn't mean that that surgeon is the best surgeon for you. It's important to actually do your own research. Find out how many cataract surgeries has that particular surgeon done. Inquire. I find that asking nurses in the surgery center are particularly good resource because they know who has good hands, so to speak. Then something that's not utilized nearly as much as I think it should be is getting a second opinion. I mean, we all inquire among our friends when we're going to buy a TV set, right? but when it comes to surgery, which I think we can all agree is more important than what brand of TV you have, we tend just to take the first surgeon that we interact with, who could be the right surgeon for you. But it's an assumption and one that should be backed by personal research.
Yeah, and a very important part of one's body to to deal with.
Yes.
Myths. Is there any, I've heard, oh, you can eat a certain food and it'll help, you know, eliminate the cataract. Yes. Talk about myths.
There's a lot of money that has been made on these alternative cures for cataracts. To date, there's no scientific evidence to suggest that any of the supplements, drops, or exercises actually work. The only thing that's been proven to address cataracts is cataract surgery.
But what about preventing it? Is there anything that we can do? You know, a lot of us are looking at computer screens a lot. We're looking at our phones.
Right.
Is there anything that we can do to hopefully prevent it from happening?
There is some evidence that exposure to ultraviolet light advances the progression of cataracts. So wearing sunglasses or hats when you're outside, sunglasses with ultraviolet protection, avoiding things such as smoking, which can also worsen cataracts, making certain that your general health is good. Diet and exercise do not directly impact cataract formation, but indirectly through things such as diabetes, which can be associated with cataracts. So if you keep yourself healthy, there's the chance that you can help push the cataracts down the line, not avoid it entirely again, but but push it down the line. And then, of course, choosing your parents well.
That's easy, so, right?
Exactly.
And your book, we understand all the proceeds are going to help with research?
Yes, that's correct. So I wrote this book primarily for my own patients and then realized that others could benefit from that. So it was just a natural step for me to decide to go ahead and give the proceeds to charities that are involved in treating eye disease.
Right. Okay, and again, the book is called So You've Got a Cataract. For more information, go to our website, kcal9.com, and click Seen on TV.
Dr. David Richardson, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Thank you.
Helpful information.
Excellent.